Team, let's open up to Poland! Great to have you here. Please sit down and make yourself comfortable. So, how are you doing today?
Oh, we're doing fine. How are you? You're looking good, so fresh.
For me, this is like a play garden for me.
Okay.
Like Eurovision.
So yeah, it was. We were waiting for that moment. I think it was like 1 month or 2 months. Really busy for us. And after this rehearsal, we are ready for the ride. I think we are so happy and happy to see you guys and say hello to all our friends and the Eurovision fans.
It seems like that you really have fun together.
I think so, because you need to have you need to be with the team, with the crew, like friends. And if the energy is okay with us, you can feel that. We want to have fun with this and have fun on the stage with the performer.
Yeah. Let's go back to the moment when you started rehearsal on that huge stage in the venue. What did you feel?
First of all, I say, okay, I'm here. What to do next? So it was really. It was something unique because, you know, I've seen probably huge stages, but here is something different. Everything is set up, everything is so huge with all the, you know, backgrounds and all the stuff. So you feel like you work with the professionals, and we were counting on that, that we can do what we need to have with our plans on the stage. So. We were waiting for the first shot for the music, and let's see what happens. Yeah, right, guys? Are you ready? Are you happy with this? There are great dancers. Of course, my friend Paul is a singer, so they have also fun with that, and they were all sweat. So you need to wait for that, you know, for that moment.
But you look really relaxed.
I don't know if we are looking good when they're relaxed. That's a good makeup, probably.
Let's do some questions from the people who are watching in our online press area.
Nice.
Hi, Rafa. This is Rafa from the Gaily Mirror. How did it feel your first rehearsal on ESC stage? Is there anything you want to improve of your performance?
Of course, it's a lot of things, because you need to change a little bit with the positions, with the cameras, with all the stuff. But I think we have the main thing right now, and we want to have another show, another rehearsal, same, to have fun on the stage with the performing. You know, if you're not thinking about how to sing, how to stay here, because we have a very energetic choreography. And so we need to move in front and back, and everything, all the positions need to be ready and set up. And that's the main reason right now to do that. And I think just only, you know, repeat that, that's okay.
Okay, let's do another question. This is from, let's see. Hi, Rafael, Andrea from Daily Magazine. Do you think that the neon lights help you in your way the best ride this year?
That's a good question. I love neons, and in the video clips and in all the visualization, we have neons from our video. And they are very famous neons, and they are. We have this photo and this video clip in the Museum of Neons in Warsaw, and they are very famous in the 80s, so this song sounds a little bit retro with the 80s. So we decided to show a very famous Polish neons, and they are famous, and they were famous, and now they are working still. So I think the colors and the neons, and that's why we need the sunglasses, of course, for that, you know, because we have a lot of neons, a lot of sun, but a color and those lights are really good for that. I think so.
Great. From Europhile Australia, what has your earlier sports career brought you that is now useful in a contest like Eurovision?
Of course,
you did some sports. I didn't.
Yeah, wrestling. It was wrestling. Yeah, but please don't let me show that. Sorry for that. I was a wrestler in the freestyle Olympic wrestling. So it was a long time ago. But if you are a sportsman, you need to think about the purpose and about the path. And if you have a good path in your mind, you know that it's step by step. You need to be prepared with the best trainers, the best people, the best director, the best choreograph, and the management, and the dancers, and the singers, everything, step by step. If you work hard, if you have a good team, you go farther. In the song, we sing that you can stumble, you can drop a little bit, but we'll never touch the ground if we have a purpose to go for the gold. And I think that's the reason, and the sports give you, your mind is set on the purpose. You need to do that. And of course you want to win or be the best, but it's step by step.
The way to success is never align like this.
Yes, of course.
Like this.
Yes, of course.
Okay, thank you. Maybe we, of course, we have some questions here in Ahoy. The gentleman is over there. Yeah, no, you. Yeah.
Okay.
Those two are big Eurovision fans.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. All the time.
Cool.
Just go ahead and introduce yourself.
JP from Wave International. Thank you for the interview you gave us.
Yes, of course. Zoom. I remember that.
Yeah. Ah, thank you. Okay. And my question is, you have been hosting Junior Eurovision.
Yes.
You are a singer. What is your passion more, hosting or singing?
Okay, so that's a good question. It's not about which passion is, or you need to choose. Because now if you are a musician, you're a contestant, you create something new. But if you're hosting, you need to create an atmosphere, you know, an energy, especially when I was hosting, we don't have an audience. So you need to create all these emotions with the people. So this is a little bit different job. Here we are performing and we're doing something, you know, fresh and new. I think if I need to choose, I want to be a musician, but it's better to compare everything. And with your, you know, that's all two passions and you can compare that. I think so.
Okay, the gentleman over here in the front, yes, go ahead.
Yes, hello, I'm Simon.
Hi.
Ready to start in Poland.
If you say, but we need to probably say in
English. Right.
Yeah.
We can speak Dutch as well. We
I don't know.
We know. <Yes. laughs>
Rafał, this journey, Eurovision journey, the theme is open up. Mm-hmm. Before coming to this journey, there is something new you didn't expect before.
Before that?
Yeah.
I mean, this journey
what
of
Eurovision. What did you open up in this Eurovision experience?
You know, open up this year, I think it's a good the good slogan here. Because you need to open up for the people. You need to open up for all the other contestants, for all the community. And finally, to show the Europe and all the people that we are in the business bag with all the musicians because of the pandemic situation is hard. There are no jobs for them, not only the musician and artists, but the crews and all the stuff. So if we say, okay, let's open up, so we send a message to all the people that we are ready to record songs and performing the songs. So I think this journey shows me that you need to believe in your dreams, and you need to be happy with your passion, and open up for all new opportunities.
How is it for you as an artist to be in a competition?
Competitions are always good because you can lose or you can win. So
it's in between.
Yeah, it's experience, you know, it's experience, and I think our life is always an experience. Everything. Sometimes you can say that it's bad. Something happened with your life that it's really bad, or you can say, all right, now I'm in a bad position. But after some time, you can say, all right, I need that for being who I am right now. So you can fall many times, but you need to believe in your dreams. So if you are in a competition, such a big like that, I don't feel this pressure. I want to be a part of this, and I think this is more important.
Yeah. But are you competitive?
Competitive, a little bit.
I think you are a winner.
You need to be. You need to focus on one purpose. And if you are a sportsman, you like to win, of course. So when it starts the show, probably you're thinking of winning always, because you need to think that.
And for Poland, it should be so amazing, if you win this competition.
Well, it was. If we win this competition, guys, we will sing it, dancing like 3 days, yeah. So it's a big, really, really huge stuff. We won in Junior Eurovision, but never in a big Eurovision. So if we did that, oh my, Bruno, dancing, you all invited.
Talking about singing and dancing, we have a question from Charlotte from Denmark. Hello, Charlotte. Thank you for sending in your question. And she's asking, please, please, please sing a bit of your song.
Okay. Sing it out. Yes. We don't have a microphone, yeah? Okay, so let's try.
One, two, three. Lights beating down the rainy street. All the faces that I meet tell me I'm wrong. And bright light of the neon sign making up the storyline. Gotta hold on, guys. Not lost even in the dead of night. I can make it all alright. Just let me go. People can see with their eye. I'll make it through somehow. Let me figure out what is in and out. Let's go on, do a fall. So baby, hold on for the ride of your life. High above ground, living it loud. I'm gonna take it to the end of the line. Taking the fight, make it alright. It doesn't matter if I stumble and fall. I'll make it through, I'll never touch the ground. So baby, hold on for the ride of your life. Hold on real tight, make it alright. Thank you.
Okay, guys, thank you very much. And Charlotte from Denmark, may we have your votes, please?
12 points goes to.
Okay, we have time for one more short question. The lady over there, please stand up. Thank you, it was a performance.
We didn't expect that, but you know, it's fun.
Hi, I'm Emilia Giacometti from Eurosong.hr, from Croatian website. I know it's probably too early to ask, but since it was only the first rehearsal, but you already did the hosting of the Junior Eurovision Song Contest. What was easier, not to step as a singer on the Eurovision stage or step as a host?
I think I'm a little bit mentioned about that, that it's, I think it's really different part, different thing. And if you are hosting, you know that, and you know that well, that you have a sketch, and you have the text, and you need to be like a little bit journalist with this, to say something, to react, whatever happens on the stage. But if you are in this position, you need to be focused on music, and I think it's, I can't say that it's easier to be a host. It's not, because you stand there and people are watching you, and you need to create the energy to them. But if you're on the stage, you can focus with your word, with your music word, and send a message through the music. And that's the most important. Music, I think, for us, for all of us, is most important.
Thank you very much. Guys, it's time. You have to move on. Yeah, all thank right. you very much.
All right, so
good energy
ready.
Performance on stage. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Time.
Thank you guys online, and hugs from
Poland.
And
how are you doing?
From Poland, and thank you for supporting us.
Thank you very much. Take the time and the photographs. Enjoy your stay in Amsterdam, and I'll talk to you after your second rehearsal.